And we are live here at Heavy Metal Stadium, the home of the Metal Meatheads, for the opening round of the TFO Blitz playoffs. Metal Stadium, in beautiful downtown Louisville, Kentucky. Here to start the TFO Blitz playoffs on Towton TFO Tuesday. You've got myself, the Killer Cactus, Frank Balog, here in the booth at Heavy Metal Stadium, alongside the man, Dave Bitzer. Dave, are you ready for some TFO Blitz playoffs?
I'm ready for some fucking football.
Alright, as you can see, we are live here in the booth, ready to go for this game. It's the Mattress Backs coming in to face the Metal Meatheads here. The 14 seed Meatheads versus the 17 seed Mattress Backs. 2 5-5 teams taking
5-5 juggernauts.
That's right, I agree. 5-5 is the way to be.
All the cool kids are doing it.
That's right, damn it. And this should be a good game. These teams a bit different. Metal Meatheads, heavy rush team, which have been dominating the Blitz. The Corpse Grinder is the star there versus the Mattress Backs. And
I don't believe these two teams met in the regular season, did they?
I don't believe they did. We could be wrong. We're not good at this.
Yes, we have literally zero anything prepared for this. So
well, we knew what the records were. That's a good thing. But, you know, the Mattress Backs, Evil Dave always makes a good defense. They're built to stop the run. So, you know, the Corpse Grinder might have a tough time running, but, you know, that heavy run defense or heavy run defense is going to be good, too. There's a lot of money to put into it.
A lot of times it just comes down to who gets ahead first and has to rely on catching up.
Yeah, if the Mattress Backs can get ahead of the Meatheads and force them to throw, you know, the heavy run teams aren't built for that. But the Mattress Backs are a passing squad, so they can be able to come back. We'll see if Brianna Banks can get in the end zone here, whether on her knees or not. But either way, should be a great game. You know, two evenly matched squads here. So before we start the game, everyone will rise for the playing of the TFO Blitz Anthem. And I think we're gonna cut to a clip here from the Raw Deal game. Actually, this happened over the weekend. A showing of silent protest here by one of the Raw Deal cards. Inside linebacker turned the tide. Shown here kneeling during the TFO Blitz anthem. You know, Raw Deal is a victim of oppression. See Magic the Gathering here. In the collectible card game community, it's really difficult. You know, there's a lot of oppression going on. Turn the Tide was victimized by Magic. He's chosen to act out in this silent protest here to try and bring some light to it. So, with that, we're going to get started with the game. The Metal Meatheads versus the Mattress Backs. Here's the coin toss. Mattress Backs get head. Never would have thought.
Figures.
And they're going to return.
All right, enough of that bullshit. Let's get some actual
football. Here we go. Hand three to kick it off.
Fake football.
Boot! Ashton gonna receive the kick here. I have beer in my hand and I'm happy.
It's a good day to be alive.
Ashton out wrecked there at the 17 yard line, so slow start here for the Mattress Backs. Jenna Jameson. Sorry about that. And we're back. I'm drinking Dave's beer.
Fucker.
Sorry about that. Brianna Banks for hardly any game. Takes up the middle again. And I'm gonna try not to use all the sexual puns here this time, but gain a few. Third down and 8. Jameson drops back while the Mattress Backs blind blew them up. Miss Raylene! Her jugs were holding her back there a little bit. Looked kind of slow.
Not enough for the first down. They have to punt it away.
Well, Raylene can't get it, so Lisa Ann's going to boot it away here to the mother.
Pretty short kick there. Not even
yards. Not a good punt, and the mother's got some moves out to the 45 of the Mattress Backs. Good field position here for the Corpse Grinder. Kill Meister's going to hand it off. Corpse Grinder looks quick, but the backs are able to stop that one. No gain, second and 16. Kill Meister going to throw early in this game. Sack Tara Patrick. One of the best defenders of the year. I don't know who had her in fantasy, but whoever had her was happy. A lot of sacks for Tara Patrick, one of the league leaders. Kill Meister to throw again. Has
same
the Corpse
play.
Grinder. There's the screen. Corpse Grinder takes off, and this could be trouble. Oh, no. Quick safety there.
But Got enough for the first down.
Yeah, did get the first down. Got a pitch to the corpse grinder. Ooh. Gets around the blitz! Dodging miss! Touchdown, corpse grinder. Dodges the evil Dave Dust for an early score.
And he gets the bro job in the end zone.
The bro job, that's right. Probably got a blow job too in this game.
Oh, that's why he lifts him up, so.
Yeah. And the extra point is donked in, and the corpse grinders have a 7-0 lead here early in the first. Actually, only half a minute left in the first. These blitz quarters go by damn fast.
I know, you think we'd be used to it by now.
Still not used to it. Ashton on the return out of her own end zone.
Slowly taking it up the left side.
Fumble the lion! It's out of bounds!
Kicked out of bounds. Luckily there for the mattress backs. Could have been disaster. Ready,
down! Still stuck deep behind there on the 9-yard line.
Jameson back to throw again. Again, ooh, looking for Raylene, but that one could have been, yeah, been a pick six
pick
there.
Pick six, easy.
He's even going to run. Man, fake the handoff to Jameson. Got Chasey Lane open deep, and they're going to try and get it to her.
All by herself.
Diving catch. On her back, up again, and back down to her back for a first down. And that's the end of the first quarter. 7-0 Metal Meatheads. There's the blitz, Zach.
Oh, Zach Wild.
Wild in there, quick, just right on top of Jenna Jameson. Not the first guy to say that. Takes the handoff, Chasey Lane again open. The Meatheads
open.
Just refused to cover Chasey Lane, but a terrible throw.
He had to come way back.
He had to come back to get it.
Doesn't matter. Walks it in.
And moonwalks her way back there. Little end zone celebration from Chasey Lane. I like it. James and Lisa Anna tied the game. It looks like we got ourselves a tie ball game here. Good answer for the Matthews back.
Back and forth and in and out.
Lots of in and out. Lisa Ann boots it off to her mother. I think I've seen that one.
Yeah, this seems to be like a weird kind of trendy thing.
Yeah. Oh, the mother looks quick. You've got to move.
But who am I?
Way up in condition. Crushed by two other women. Ready, down, but a good return out to the 26. Here's Killmeister with the handoff down. There goes the corpse grinder.
And throws one woman off.
And out the 20-yard gain. Good run there by the grinder. First down, we're going to fake the handoff. Oh, not fooled. There's Tara Patrick. She's in there again. The Meatheads, they're going to throw the ball. They're going to have to keep Tara Patrick out of the backfield. She will cause havoc back there. There's the blitz. The corpse grinder. Ooh, nowhere to go.
Right into that.
Ground down. Ready, down. Put. Third and 25 here for Lenny. And they're going to run the Statue of Liberty. Oh, but
no,
Abbott.
Unsuccessful.
He's slow as shit and can't get it out of his hands. Meatheads are going to have to punt. Mattress backs with excellent defense. They're just not good.
Trying to be creative.
And a big kick here from Hank 3. Well, this will have to get down. Down. Oh,
too deep.
Just a little bit deep. He went balls deep on that one. Jameson gonna give it to Banks up the middle again. Nowhere to go.
No fool.
Man, Brianna Banks just can't get anything going here on the ground. Not gonna let the Meathead move.
Oh, and a rush in the atomic clock, Rex.
The atomic clock for the sack. Third and 21 here. Mattress backs really need to get something other than Chasey Lane going on offense.
Or maybe not.
Everybody's covered up. Oh, Brianna Banks sneaks out of the backfield. What a skull, but tackled short of the first down, fourth and six.
30 seconds to go in the half.
And a smart play by Jameson there to check it down to Banks, but she just couldn't make the run after the catch work. The punt is away. The mother is going to try and return this again.
Much better punt this time.
Yeah, good punt from Lisa Ann, all the way down to the five here. The mattress backs are on top.
We don't get another play.
Oh, it's halftime. Wow.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah.
These quarters are going bad. So, 7-7 here at the half. Who gets the ball?
No, because the mattress backs got ahead.
Oh, that's right. The mattress backs got ahead. So, panties! Panties are here. Corpse grinder going to get the ball back. And that could be the swing of this game. One possession either way. These quarters are so short.
Very tight.
Corpse grinder can score. Very tight. And the mother again. The mother, wow, man. Great returns here. She looks
not
really
good.
All the way out to almost a midfield. Great return there by the mother. Setting up the pitch down with the corpse grinder here.
Oh,
Matress Max had the right defense call, but it doesn't
matter. Corpse Grinder gonna take 20, it all 15, the way.
10, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, touchdown. Corpse Grinder.
Wow, he's bouncing back after that hurricane endeavor.
That's true. He sure is. Matress Max had the right defense called there, you know. Other than the blitz, I mean, they had the block, they had the guys down there to make that, or the girls, I should say, down there to make that play. Corpse Grinder just said, get fucked.
He did.
Oh, Hank 3 gonna boot it. So 14-7 here. These Matress backs again are gonna have to answer. I feel like if the Metal Meatheads can just cover Chasey Lane, you know, put a guy or two on her. She likes that.
Mm-hmm. Or and, five.
Yeah, if they cover her up, I mean, there's nothing. They haven't really been able to get anything else going on offense here. They've got a ton of clock in there again.
Defense is being stout.
Yeah, there are a lot of sacks in this game, but gonna have to get something going here from their own five. The blitz
close to safety territory.
Ooh, on the clock again.
On the one, it looks like.
Third and 30 from the 1 centimeter line.
If that, man.
Banks out. Just gonna try and get some room to punt.
Wise decision
out,
here.
Yeah, Banks out to the 9. We're gonna have to kick it away. I don't know. I might have tried to go for the throw there. You know, you can't really block punts in the TFO unless you're the fucking Sunday Knights.
That's true.
So, but
I've gotten a couple.
Still, yeah, we've got a broken player too. Well, Banks down there to make a great play. At least they got good coverage, so not great field position off of that. Deep in the run. There's Tara Patrick again! Wow, this woman just keeps coming and coming and coming. Oh no, it's Boner! Boner!
The one male on the Matress Backs.
The TFO legend, Boner, gets in there. I mean, could there be a better legend for the Matress Backs to have drafted? Seriously.
Yeah.
They have all those women and one Boner.
Someone's got to do it.
Share it all. There's this rollout. Killmeister's got... Oh, neg roll.
Oh, out of bounds.
Not sure really what happened there. Just must have had a little bit of bodily fluid left on the ball.
It gets sticky. Ball sticks in your hand. Gripping too tight.
Hank 3 is going to punt it away. Ashton really needs a good return. They need to get some momentum going here for her team. Block the Corpse Grinder. She does try to make a move, but she's just too fucking slow. In the third quarter, this game paid for by the TFO Blitz League cannot be rebroadcast, retransmitted, reduplicated, or resuscitated without the express written consent of the TFO Blitz, the RAJ, the Kinky K, the VGV, and UPS. They're delivering with drones nowadays. There's not even going to be any more fucking trucks.
Do they still have to wear brown pants?
I think the drones need to be painted brown at all times. Matress Backs, again, still can't get anything going here. Sack and a failed run to Brianna Banks in his 3rd and 21. They're all in. Whoa. Have to throw it away. Oh, they're going to have to go for it here on 4th down and 21, but I totally expect Evil Dave to get this, by the way. There's no way he does not convert here on 4th and 21. Just calling it now. And there's Chasey Lane.
Oh, of course.
Oh, wow, he didn't get it. I can't believe it. The Matress Backs
with
give
the field
it up
position,
on downs.
This might be the game. Corpse Grinder, Corpse got the Grinder open lane.
Put it away here. Throws two.
Oh,
women.
No.
The Corpse Grinder will not be denied. I think that might spell disaster here for the Mavs.
It's a tough double to climb. Got 14 with only what?
Down
two
scores with one.
Ooh, less than two minutes to go.
Less than two to go. Down two touchdowns. But if anyone can come back here, it's Evil Day. I'll tell you right now. So. I still fully expect him to score here and get the onside kick. But again, they're gonna have to either get Chasey Lane open or find some other options on offense. We're gonna have to go 77 yards to do it here.
As little time possible here.
16. Jameson back to throw. Right.
Oh, uncovered.
Has time. Chasey Lane's open. They're gonna get it to her.
And yeah.
She's got a first down
and
more
got
the
lane. Oh!
Yeah, pass midfield, so a good gain there by Chasey Lane. They're gonna call their last time out here. With 1:24 to go. They're going to have to score here, though. Pretty soon, they're going to need to score. Here's that play where Lane's been open. She's got a step.
She's got a step.
And she does the job.
Oh, my God.
Chasey Lane, she's the whole team.
Pretty much.
She is taking on every Metal Meathead by herself right now.
Yourself.
Well, Jenna Jameson's helping. I guess it's the two.
She's lending a hand.
That's true, lending a hand. Ooh. So the kick is up and good, and Evil Dave's got a minute left if he can get this onside kick back.
And onside kick is very short. Can they get
Matches got
it covered?
And they got
they
it!
Got it covered!
I mean, I'm not going to say I called
fucking
it.
Fucking bullshit.
Not going to say I called it, but It's a minute warning to go, but Brianna Banks is going to get stuffed. Not sure why they're running here. 53 seconds. Gotta look for Chasey Lane.
Might as well. It's worked so
Here's
far.
The fake.
Oh, she was by the atomic clock.
That's the story of this game. Lane was open, but the atomic clock saving his team again. But same formation here. Like, oh, and again!
Atomic clock is not fooled.
The atomic clock is winning this game for the Meatheads, fourth and ball game.
You'd expect him.
They're gonna run it again, and the atomic clock says, "Fuck you!" Fuck, Evil Dave. The atomic clock will not be denied, and the Meatheads are gonna run the clock out here with the corpse grinder,
barring some strange fumble.
This. Game. Unbelievable. The atomic clock, the clear MVP. For some reason, we're going to run the Statue of Liberty on the last play.
And. Oh, broken up.
Tried for the interception, batted down. But
ball game.
Ball game. What a performance by the atomic clock. I believe he had 6 sacks in that game.
That's fucking ridiculous.
3 on the final drive in a row to seal the victory for the Meatheads. What a performance.
Chasey Lane, 5 receptions for 183 in a losing effort.
Just not enough. Jetta Jameson, a good showing. 201 yards passing on 77% completions. I mean, they let it all out. They let it all hang out.
They
really did. But the atomic clock, just too much. And the corpse grinder, 7 carries for $1.43.
It's a good average.
Didn't need much more than that. I mean, he scored basically on every other play. And added a catch for 25 yards and a score, so... Corpse Grinder, 3 touchdowns here, 168 total yards, and he is not the MVP of this game. It's the atomic clock.
Yeah, easily.
Just could not be denied. So
it's basically, it was him versus the entire team almost.
Unbelievable game, but congratulations to the Metal Meatheads. They'll be moving on to the second round. I think that's Billy DeVore's team, so congratulations to him. The Matress backs will be going home here. Evil Dave put a valiant effort up, but just there was no stopping the atomic clock here.
There was not. No, it was just bad matchup for that front line. There's no coming back from that.
Yeah, it was tough. So, thanks, guys. This wraps it up for us. We'll catch you again on the next Toutin' TFO Tuesday.